not the kind of band that picks up a new crew every tour. When we find guys we like, it's like you can check in anytime you like, but you can never leave. Michael Richter has been our production manager now for 14 years. Anytime Michael mentions the Boston Celtics, the New England Patriots, or the Boston Red Sox, I'd appreciate if you could just bleep it. Oh, did you have to? Really?
My office.
The first time Michael worked for us was a show in Reno, Nevada. Now, this is before I knew where his professional sports loyalty went.
They were looking for a production manager. The guy they had helping them was a friend of mine, and off I went to Reno, thinking I was gonna just do maybe 5 or 6 shows and that was it.
He came in and nailed it.
14 years later, here we are.
Having that consistency in the production management for the band, it's huge. The first representative of REO Speedwagon that any venue sees is Michael Richter.
I am the first guy in the door. I could be the difference between us getting invited back or not. That weighs heavily on my mind every day. It's tough because far be it for me to be the reason the band can't go back and play in whatever city. It's a tightrope walk sometimes, but
I mean, it always is. I mean, I don't know how you guys get there in the morning, unload the trucks, the light trusses go up, the sound goes up, the stage is built from scratch. Every day.
Yeah, we got a great crew. It's a total team effort, and there's a ton of work that goes in well in advance of even setting foot into the venue on the day of a show. I call every venue we go to and I work out all the details. Here's when we're coming, here's how much equipment we're bringing, and so on. Once I get in the building on the day of the show, I find the layout of the building, figure out what dressing rooms the bands are going into, where production is, where catering is. Then we go to load in. Then I meet the band when they show up, bring them in the building, we do a sound check. I go get them at showtime, put them on stage, get them off stage. Then it's load out, tear the whole thing down and make it go away.
Our theory with REO Speedwagon is always that when everybody in the organization does their job well, boom, it's magic. And for us, we got a pretty good batting average. Over the years, you know, we've played a lot of gigs, but there are few that really become part of the REO folklore. And the one that we videoed was Moondance Jam. From our end, it was a riot. Now, Mike, it may have been a nightmare for you guys.
So we worked all night, put up lighting and video, and we supplemented what they had. And the production was great. You guys played great. The crowd response was unbelievable. It was awesome.
And we played that festival probably at least 3 times over the years. But that particular night, the stars lined up, man.
And then Ozark.
Yeah?
They wanted to stage an REO Speedwagon concert, and they wanted it to be absolutely as realistic as possible, to the point where we brought our truck and we brought our gear. Then we got into the challenges of how to do that, because the space on top of the boat where the band performed wasn't large. It all worked out great in the end. They couldn't have been nicer people, and it was a thrill just because I was a fan to begin with.
That was awesome. It was the first time that my kids and my wife all thought I was cool at the same time. You know, we need to address the 6,000-pound gorilla in the room for all of us in the touring industry. Everybody is scrambling, and this is tough on you, you know, just on a personal and a business level.
100%. I've spent 200 to 250 days a year on the road the last 5 years in a row. You go from being incredibly busy all the time to absolutely having nothing to do. It's hard to fathom. It's hard to believe. I still can't believe it.
There's no entertainment anywhere on the freaking planet. I mean, it's mind-boggling.
All of a sudden, we're all home, sitting here going, oh my God, what am I going to do? How am I going to bring money in? Crew Nation is giving money to touring crew people like myself to try to help them out during this pandemic, which I think is amazing because we're not working, but the bills aren't going away.
It's a different life that we live. So when something like this happens, a lot of people are on their own. From the band standpoint, our crew, they're basically band members. We travel as a family, so when Crew Nation comes up and offers financial assistance to crew guys, well, they're kind of helping the bands too.
For me, the first show back, the first word that comes to mind is relieved. We're gonna be back at work, we're gonna be getting paid, and we're going to have purpose again, because my purpose in life has been swept out from under my feet. overnight. I just can't wait. I'm ready to go. We all are.
It's going to be exciting, obviously, to walk out on stage for the first time. I'm sure the audiences will be just so ready to rock. I can't wait for it. I miss seeing the guys. I miss seeing the band guys, the crew guys. We love it. We have a great time.
Thanks for doing this, Casey, taking the time.
Yeah, no, it was really fun, Michael. Good to hang out with you.
Yeah, you too. I appreciate it, you know. So let's go to work.
To lend a hand to the crews, go to livenation.com/crewnation.